Yeah, it started.
It started?
Yeah.
We can edit it, right?
Yeah, we can edit.
So, the topic of our presentation is error analysis and estimation. In science, the word error means the uncertainty which accompanies every measurement. No measurement of any sort is complete without a consideration of this inherent error. We cannot avoid the uncertainties by being very careful. So, how do we deal with the measurement errors? All we can do is to try to ensure that they are as small as possible and have a reliable estimate of how large they are. An important component of science is to learn how to handle and interpret experimental data and results. This includes the development of methodologies needed to estimate the error inherent in various types of measurements and techniques for testing data to find out if these error estimates are valid, and the understanding of the way errors propagate through calculations made using experimental data. Learning how to handle experimental errors is also very useful in engineering. There are two main types of errors associated with an experimental result. They are precision and accuracy. The precision is usually described as the variation you see when you measure the same physical entity repeatedly with the same device. Accuracy is related to the existence of systematic errors, for example, incorrect calibration. As you can see in this diagram, the first diagram represents a perfectly accurate and precise measurement since all the points lie together and they also agree with the actual results. On the next diagram, the readings are precise as they lie together, but they are not accurate since they do not agree with the actual results at all. In the third diagram, the results are accurate, they agree with the actual results, but they are not precise, they are scattered. In the fourth diagram, they are neither accurate nor precise. Moving on to major sources of error. The major sources of error are reading error, random error, and systematic error. Reading error refers to the uncertainties caused by the limitations of our measuring equipment and or our own limitations at the time of measurement. This does not refer to any mistakes you make while taking the measurement. Rather, it refers to the uncertainty inherent to the measurement and your own ability to minimize this uncertainty. A reading error affects the precision of the experiment. Random error. Random errors refers to the spread in the values of a physical quantity from one measurement of the quantity to the next, caused by random fluctuations in the measured value. This type of error also affects the precision of the experiment. We assume that the best estimate of the measured value is the average value of many measurements. Standard deviation is also one of the methods to calculate the spread of our readings from the mean value. Systematic errors. Systematic errors refers to an error which is present for every measurement of a given quantity. It may be caused by a bias on the part of the experimenter or a non-calibrated or even faulty measuring instrument. Systematic errors affect the accuracy of the experiment and not the precision. Examples of such errors in scales can be reduced by calibration using wavelength of lasers, etc. Considering the fact that LIGO recently discovered the gravitational waves, which was an amazing discovery. The accuracy of LIGO was 1000th the diameter of a proton, which is very, very precise. And this was obtained by using an interferometer. So, formal representations of error can be done by using significant figures. Following significant figures throughout the calculation of the experiment helps to maintain a uniformity. Also, other ways of representing errors include percentage error representations and relative error representations. The formulas are given in the script. In many experiments, it is very useful to make a rough graph of data points as they are being taken in order to make sure that the experimental data makes sense. Carefully drawn and analyzed graphs are often the best ways to extract the values of the unknowns and to confirm or deny the theoretical prediction being tested. You also need to show the uncertainty in each point of your graph. This is done by drawing the error bars. The error bars are the lines corresponding to the size of the error on either side of the data point. As you can see in this diagram, the error lies in the y-axis of measurement. Hence, the error bars are along the y-axis. Using computers to fit data. So, we are going to explain an online software called plot.ly to briefly explain how we can do error analysis using online softwares. This is the software that we are using to explain how softwares can be used for error analysis. The values corresponding to the x coordinate are these values correspond to the Brewster's angle data. The values along the x coordinate are the intensity of the are the angle of the measurement, and the values are on y are the corresponding intensities measured. They are plotted against the y coordinate. So we'll first plot a scatter. We'll first make a scatter plot of this. So the scatter plot looks like this. Now, as we know that the Brewster, we can fit this data to a quadratic curve. So we will try to fit this to a quadratic curve, and so when we run this fit, we get a pretty smooth quadratic fit, and we can see that the Brewster's angle lies at the minima, which is around 57 degrees, which actually agrees pretty well with our actual data. And as you can see, these are all the parameters related to this. So in this way, we can use online softwares and other softwares like Origin to fit in our data. And so we would like to end our presentation with this, and thank you.